We shall go on to the end. We shall fight in France. We shall fight on the seas and oceans. We shall fight with growing confidence and growing strength in the air. We shall defend our island, whatever the cost may be. We shall fight on the beaches. We shall fight on the landing grounds. We shall fight in the fields and in the streets. We shall fight in the hills. We shall never surrender.
We'll be right back. Been a long time since we saw you. The last time was on the Peace of Mind album and tour, I think, down here in Long Beach Arena. Gonna do a song for you now off that album. The song's called The Trooper! Let me see your hands in the air! Peace of Mind, but you might remember on the Number of the Beast album, we got all this crap from people about them. What was it? Devil worshippers and all that kind of stuff and everything over here. Are Iron Maiden satanic? The answer is no, we're not. And we wish these people would go and fuck off and die or crawl into a corner or something, you know? Climbing on my tits and making a nuisance of themselves. Right, here's a song of the Peace of Mind album called Revelations. This road!
Take life by thunder, promise.
As you might know, we've got a new album wandering around at the moment. The album is called Power Slave, all right? What we thought we'd do on this one, rather than like the usual, you know what I mean, 3.5 minute hit single and all that stuff and get on all the usual bullshit kind of shows and all the rest of it. What we thought we'd do is we'd do something a little different. We did a song on this album that's about 13 minutes long, right? This little track I'm going to do for you. Written by a guy a very long time ago, a guy by the name of Samuel Taylor Coleridge, actually wrote a poem on which this song is based, all right? And this poem, I'm sad to say, was written while under the influence of drugs, ladies and gentlemen. Now, we're not talking here the kind of drugs that I normally take, which is maybe the odd cup of tea or something like that, you know, before a concert or something. We're talking serious drugs. Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about marijuana, ladies and gentlemen. Do you know this stuff used to be legal in the 19th century in England, all right? In those days, they didn't used to call it marijuana. They used to call it hemp, right? Which is the stuff they used to make ropes out of in those days. And did you know that the Queen of England, that's Queen Victoria, who was the Queen of England in those days, she used to get really, really bad period pains, you know what I mean? Really terrible. And in her diary, she used to write, had really terrible period pains today. Georgie was very annoyed. That was her husband, the King, you know what I mean? And she used to go to the toilet and have a couple of joints to kind of mellow out a little bit. Did you know that? Really? And now look what's happened to the state of the fucking empire. Never mind. The rhyme of the ancient mariner! Yeah.
side you'll glow. With every thump, a lifeless lump, they drop down, one by one.
And by the light Until the rears Let him who hath understanding reckon the number of the beast.
For it is a human number.
Its number is 666.
I left alone. My mind was blank.
We'll be right back.
You're amazing tonight, really. Have you heard the noise you lot are making out here? It's unbelievable. We've got Martin Birch in the back there in the truck complaining of swollen eardrums from the audience microphones, all right? So let's hear a Los Angeles cheer for the video crew at the back here. Let's hear it. Come on! Come on, you can do a little bit better than that. Let's hear you scream, come on! On the guitar over here, will you welcome, please, Mr. Adrian Smith, yeah? Over here on the guitar, Mr. Dean Murray! On the bass guitar and orange juice, Mr. Steve Harris. You ain't gonna believe this, what this idiot is wearing tonight. This man is the craziest person I know, all right? This is the most lunatic person I think I've ever met in my born days. On the drums, Mr. Nick Herman-Brain. Preferred him with a mask on, actually. Run to the house! Come out! All right, let me see those hands in the air, everybody! Come on, everybody!
Back to their homes, fighting them at the
I just want to hear those people on the right hand side. I want to hear you scream real loud. Come on. Tonight. Who have I forgotten? Left and straight! Oh! Left hand side have been down the pub before the show. I know, yeah, I can tell you've been having a few pints, haven't you? You know what I mean? Before the show, getting off, yeah. I know your sort. You gotta beat, all right, you hear you, what you gotta beat? Come on, now we hear you now, let me hear you. All right. Sing! Oh. They got it. I don't know what they've been taking, but whatever they're on, you should get some of it, all right? Because they're fucking loud over here. Sing it! In the band and everybody to do with it, we just want to express our gratitude to you people in Los Angeles for coming tonight, because you've made our evenings really. You've been a fantastic crowd tonight. Like I say, we are filming it, and you are the audience that's going to be seen around the world with Iron Maiden, all right? So you've done us proud tonight, thank you. Really. We were doing an interview today, actually, doing this interview with this guy from his TV station. And he said, what do you think of the fact that your band doesn't get a lot of media attention, you know, like... You know, like some bands, you know what I mean? Like, you go out and you turn on the TV and you turn on, what is it, MTV, right? And you turn on MTV and there's a band on every 5 minutes, you know? And they come and play concerts and they can't sell out a fucking toilet, all right? And... Yeah, on MTV, they're really big stars, all right? And this guy goes, I don't understand how Iron Maiden never gets played on MTV and how loads of places don't play it on the radio around America. And yet you sell out 4 nights at Los Angeles, you know, in Long Beach Arena. happening? What's going on? Well, I'll tell you what's going on. What's going on is that the only thing this band is bothered about is music, right? We're not bothered about selling fucking clothes. We're not bothered about selling jeans or selling pimple cream or selling some fucking stupid product that they want to put on their radio stations and make money. I don't give a shit about music anymore after these people, all right? And you people here are the living proof that there are some people in the world who care about music more than about fucking the money in their pocket, all right? For that, thank you, and just God bless you, you're fucking brilliant tonight. It's a song called Sanctuary! tonight. Look, have a safe journey home. Look after yourselves. And have a great weekend, all right?